there is a great gap. It's politics politicians deal with, and them deal with them friends and them whatever, and they abuse the poorest of the poor, and this is happening globally. You know, it's not just Jamaica, but Jamaica is no different. So the Rastafari is that voice of reason, because not only were we considered low class, underclass, no class, you know, see, them never even want us in them class, you overs. But yet still, I and I know that we, as children called by this new name of Rastafari, have to do the work that our Holy Father chose, our Holy Mother, based on what the woman come to represent. So when we talk about Empress of Zion, we are not the Empress of Zion. We are the daughters of Zion. The Empress of Zion is our Holy Mother, Empress Menin Asfa. It is she and her own personal funds that provided the infrastructure and opportunity for little girls, for the first time to be educated in Ethiopia. Because by the time them turn, even from 8, 9 years old, according to certain religions and certain culture, they were married off. You understand? And she had to stop that. And she became one of those individuals who was married off at a very early age. So by the time she was chosen by our Holy Father to restore the balance of the African family of man, woman, and child, she had already been married 3 times to nobility, and she'd already given birth to children from those marriages, to show that His Majesty had the opportunity to have chosen a virgin, but is not according to those things that one is looking at now. When you have to rebuild a nation, when you have to repair a people broken and scorned, you know, you have to go through to those who are the survivors. And that's who we are. We are the survivors, the daughters of Zion. We are the one that we coined the term breaking the conspiracy of silence. We are the one that saying yes is the preacher man. Yes is the policeman, my mother, husband, friend who put the gun on my head and raped me. Yes, we are breaking the conspiracy of silence. And we believe our youth when they tell us, you of us. So we have to prepare ourselves now that we have to start repairing ourselves before we can even look at anyone else. And that's what we are doing. And Empress of Zion is that organization globally that provides technical assistance. And we are in different parts of the world. And we show that the resources that we need are within us, the Rastafari. Every single year, since 2002, we have put on a global conference somewhere in the world, including Africa, every single year, without any funding from any external sources. Let's give ourselves a nice round of applause for self-reliance and showing that we have all we need. Because let me tell you something. You see, all we need, we just need a venue. Because when we have a venue, it's going to happen. You know, see? Because we have the resources, we have the capacity. You have a consultant that came to our community as a consultant and said that we're stupid. So because we're stupid and we don't have the capacity to do for ourselves and our community, this consultant decided that they're going to hijack our community and do their own thing without any input from I and I. Yet still we hear that our names of our organizations are on documents, you know, so ones can get funding. And give the funding to who? When we are the ones doing with our little nothing. Because all I and I, you know, see, no one gets paid.